see, we're right back in our neighborhood now. And you can see that even at low speeds, even in the neighborhoods, you know, with stop signs and speed bumps, this car is fairly well composed for what a monster it truly is.
Yeah, and you know what? With the exhaust that it's got, so just so everybody knows, it's got factory exhaust manifolds. It has factory replacement catalytic converters and a factory Y-pipe with a third cat in it. Post-cats, which includes the third cat, is the 3-inch mandrel bent exhaust. Considering it's got a 3-inch mandrel bent exhaust, there is zero droning inside the car.
No drone at all.
It has less drone in this car than my car, which has a resonator and a super quiet thermal muffler on it. And I get drone in my car, which bugs me now that this car doesn't. I want to completely rebuild mine now. But everything is real smooth and easy. We have a lot of speed bumps and stop signs in our community. No need to rev it up because the clutch is too aggressive or something like that. It'll bog down. No NASCAR pit stop releases or anything like that. Nice and smooth.
And how's the clutch activation? Heavy clutch, light clutch?
It's a light clutch. It's a stage one pressure plate. It's got a 6-puck solid disc in it. So that's the only thing that you need to play with. But in reality, it's so smooth. The engagement period is a good 2.5-3 inches. So it's very easy to do. And there's no clutch chatter, which is very surprising with a solid 6-puck clutch, which I'm very happy about. I do have pictures of this adapter plate, shifter, and everything that I got from Drift HQ. It's on my Instagram, which is 3UZISF. And I had some pictures of parts. I had pictures of the motor and transmission when it was mated together before it went in. I have pictures of where I needed to clearance on the car, in the subframe, and in the tunnel to have this motor and tranny go in nice and smooth. It has factory motor mounts that were brand new, so it's nice and smooth if you want. I do recommend excessive manufacturing or engineering motor mounts if you want something a little more aggressive. It does have polyurethane rear BMW mounts in it, and you hear the clutch now that it's been a little warmed up, the clutch diff. But other than that, it drives really nice. Around neighborhoods, you can be nice and quiet and chill. No need to piss off any neighbors. I never even have a person look at me as I drive by when people are out walking because it's so subtle, the car. But when you open it up, it's a monster.
Phenomenal. Is there anything else you'd like to share with the potential buyer for this vehicle?
Of course, now that I'm on the spot, I can't think of anything, but of course you guys send information or questions in. I built this thing by hand from the ground up. When I got it, it had a blown, it actually did not have a blown motor. It had a GTE motor with an R154 sitting in it, but nothing was hooked up. It was just sitting on motor mounts and that was it. So I took that out and did everything else. You know, it could use a new front bumper. It could use a paint job or a wrap. Few things I will still do. I'm gonna put the front fender liners in, and I think hook up the fog lights. I believe that's all I forgot to do so far. And of course, I just remembered it.
Well, amazing. Thank you for sharing your build with us, and good luck to the future owner.